single man in here knows what it's like to come on the face of a millionaire. Sure, you've gotten head, but have you ejaculated onto a great American mind, huh? Has your sperm swam in the eyes of an icon, huh? Have you been deep-throated by a voice of a generation? I don't think so. It's highly unlikely that any man in here, well, any straight man in here, knows what it's like to come on the face of a millionaire. First of all, how many female self-made millionaires are there to begin with? And then out of that pool, how many of them gonna let you come on their face? There's three of us, okay? Yeah, I don't even know who the other two are. You think Ellen gonna let you come on her face? You think Oprah gonna let you go to Montecito and stomp on all her vegetables? I love to get cummed on the face. I do. Because it's so nasty and it's so easy. It is so easy, especially when you compare it to sucking dick, which is so physically taxing. Oh, the choking, the eyes watering. And if you really want to keep it 100, you got to add the pepper grinding. It's a lot, you know? Whenever I get a deep tissue massage, the masseuse is always like, oh, do you sit and work at a computer all day? I'm like, no, I sucked dick last night. Now I can't look to the left. I want to have it all. I want to have a family, a career, and a side piece. The greatest trick women ever played on ourselves was making us believe that having it all was limited to having a family and a career. I got both of those things. Newsflash, it's not enough. Necesito más. I don't just want equal pay, I want equal pleasure. But it would be very threatening if all women wanted and felt like they deserved that, because then a bunch of women wouldn't be available to helping their husbands make their lives as easy as possible. Do you know how much more successful I would be if I had a wife? Fruit besides bananas and put the duvet cover on the duvet. People don't like it when women cheat, you know, and they'll really turn on you because they feel betrayed, especially if you're a mom. It's too contrary to your wholesome, loving image. And that's why I'm trying to let all of you know now that I'm a real piece of shit, okay? I want you to really listen to me and understand this and believe me so that you're not shocked or surprised, so that you don't abandon me when you see the TMZ video of my face getting fire hosed by Michael B. Jordan. while I chant Wakanda forever.
It. At the beginning of a relationship with a guy, I just assume anything nice he does is a move he pulls on everybody. And I'm not gonna fall for your choreography, sir. I'm like, oh, is this your move? You open the car door for me on the date? This is like your move? This is how you do it? It's cute. Bet that works a lot. Oh, is this your move? You go with me to my grandpa's funeral, hold an umbrella over my head in the rain. This is like your move. This is how you do it. Like, oops, don't get wet. Oops, I am. Whatever. This ain't my first rodeo. I used to have two grandpas. Oh, is this your move? You die next to me in a hospital bed at 86 years old, holding my hand for all eternity. This is like your move? This is how you get pussy? He's like, we've been together for 60 years. I'm like, you're a fuck boy, and I know it. Don't bury me with this guy. He's been dying with other people behind my back. I can't prove it. Check his phone when he uses the bedpan. That's why we're in therapy.
A lot of things have changed, but not the audacity of men. I did not miss talking, hearing, interacting with men at all. I'm not a man hater, let me just say that. I know that's the wave. I'm not a man hater, but I always give them the benefit of the doubt, you know? I have to believe that they don't know how fucking weird and creepy they been all the goddamn time, you know what I mean? I have to believe that, or I won't go outside. You know what I mean? I feel like that's how most women operate. You know what I mean? We like, I know there's some good ones out there, right? That's how we think, so we can go about our life, you know? I heard my sister married one. Her brother, he was a good man. That's how we do it, you know what I mean? I heard one time, now, he dead, but I know. I'm a comedian, I ride in Ubers, I come home late, 3 a.m. sometimes, how dare me, I know. But these drivers, they pull up to the house, it's 3 a.m., they say shit like, you live here alone? Like, why would you say that? Why don't you know that's creepy? That's happened to me multiple times, you live here alone. Like, 20 minutes of silence, this is what you choose to say. And when you choose to say it, what is happening right now? They turn you into a liar. You gotta be like, no, it's just me and my two husbands. And our pit bulls, you know. We run a pit bull academy if you wanna come by. It sucks, because I love Ubers. That's how I pretend that I'm rich. I get in, I'm like, drive. That's my shit. And they fuck it up for me. I want to take naps and shit in the Uber, but you can't nap in the Ubers, right? Not with a male driver, ladies, we know that. Can't sleep. Can't even catch a wink. Every once in a while, I get a female driver, that little thing pops up. I see the woman face. I'm like, ah, just light a joint. I'm about to relax. You know what I mean? I love it. Not with the male driver. Can't do that. You gotta, you know? Gotta let them see the whites, you know? You gotta not only be awake, you gotta make sure they know you're awake. So that's posture and, you know? I like to roll the window up and down. Am I cold? Am I hot? What I am is awake. Gotta fart everyone. Oh, that was me. That was me. I would not touch me if I were you, sir. Oh, that's a wet one. That was, ooh. I am so unrapeable. I can't even. Gotta stay alive. I've only fallen asleep one time with a male driver. I remember it like it only happened once. That's why I remember it so clearly. I was sleeping And you ever hit the Law and Order, chung chung, like in your head? I thought it was on the radio, it was so clear, like chung chung, and it was just my brain, my alert, like, what the fuck you doing? And, you know? And sure enough, that widow was staring at me dead in my eyeballs, and he didn't look away. That's a murderer. Right? That's a murderer. Same people know, you get caught staring, hey, sorry, you know what I mean? They're embarrassed. No, he was, you know what I mean? And you know, I live in New York, so I'm like, you know what I mean? But he didn't look away. That was 10 minutes of extended eye contact on that ride. I'm farting for my life in the back. It was crazy.
Because I grew up right here in Atlanta, Georgia, doing the 80s, y'all, doing Ronald Reagan era. Oh, my God. Y'all remember that shit? Reaganomics, nigga. We were so motherfucking poor, no lie. I had a dog named Pupo. When Reagan got reelected, the nigga jumped out the back porch and committed suicide. Don't look at me like that. I didn't kill the nigga. He killed his damn self. That's why I understand all this new shit. You know, with people going around putting their pets down and shit. The new shit, putting your dog down. My friend called me like, girl, I had to put my dog Coco Chanel down. I'm like, for what, bitch? Somebody, she had breast cancer. I'm like, how the fuck you gonna kill a dog who still got 7 good titties to go? Ain't nobody trying to kill you when one of your fucking titties go out. I don't understand that shit. I'm like, how you know that dog didn't want to walk for a cure? Bitch, that dog want a t-shirt to say, I beat cancer too. That dog want to hear Heart of an Angel his damn self. Look at all you pet lovers. How dare you, Miss Pat? Fuck you, you crazy. And it's not cheap to put your pet down. It costs you $799. I'll be damned if I'm gonna pay you $799 to put my fucking dog down. Nigga, not when I got a barbecue grill in my backyard. Fuck you, heat is heat, bitch. No matter who applied. Oh, are you judging me because I'm not going to put the ashes in a cupcake box with a picture on top? Oh, fuck you. I can't stand you fucking animal lovers. I fly every fucking week, y'all, and I'm so tired of getting on Delta, seeing everybody with these fake-ass emotional support animals. It can't be that many people out there that need a fucking friend. Did y'all see the lady who tried to get on the plane with the short horse? I'm like, who the fuck out here writing prescriptions for short horses? And what's the copay on this nigga? But that's just their way of flying shit free. I'm gonna do the same thing with my 4 crack babies. I'm gonna show up at Delta with my 4 crack babies with them same vests on. And I'm gonna tell them, these are my emotional support niggas. Don't fuck with them, cause they bite.
Are there black people here? Ooh, yes! I got one right in the front! Yes, Rosa sat for us all! And it's not just buses. Can I? You a question.
Please.
Okay, so at the height of the Black Lives Matter protests last summer, I don't know about you, but every single white person I blinked at, waved at, smiled at, kicked a leg up at, texted me. I heard a lot of white laughter. They were like, yes, I texted. But did they text you? Yeah, did the text message say, if there's anything I can do, let me know? Yes, what the fuck, white people? Your only black friend? Keep that shit locked in your heart. Also, I don't need anything. I'm alive. But I gotta say, I was deeply, truly offended that the only white people who didn't text me were all the white dudes I ever fucked. I was like, excuse me, do black lives only matter when you're inside of one?